You give and you receive. There's an old story about that. I think you know it. And that's the truth. Also, tell the truth. Say it like it is. Don't lie. You lie, you lie like a rug. You be stepped on. So, without further ado, I'll tell you a little bit about my family. I'm from Miccosukee. We're a small tribe. We're 350 after the Seminole Wars in the 60s. Actually in the 1800s, but we were recognized in the 1962. We were recognized by the federal government as an American Indian tribe. So before that, we were just nobody. We weren't even citizens. We weren't even on the census. So, 1962, my dad, well before that, 2 years before that, he had to go down to Cuba because the Spanish government down there recognized the Miccosukees because we were on the in the archives of Sevilla, Spain, as a treaty. We had a treaty with the Spanish government in the 1600s. So, my father knew, the folks down there knew, they came together. The guys up here said, well, these guys are mean business. They're going down to Cuba right now in 58, 59. Some heavy stuff, trying to talk about stuff during that time. You know, we want to talk about going down to Cuba, talking Catholic. My family did it. They went down there, so federal government, it was a way. It was a means to the way, a way to the means of us being recognized on this earth as a tribe and getting recognition by the federal and the state governments that we'll never lose our land base out there west on Panhandle Trail or the Miccosukee Resort is. Hotel, resort, or gaming, we call it. And a lot of people say, well, what's the difference between you guys and Seminole Hard Rock guys? I said, we're really nothing. Two parties. I mean, my family, my children are all Seminole. I'm Miccosukee. My father was Buffalo Tiger, the guy that went down to meet the guy down there, down south on that big island. Cuba, and so I'll probably never change my party. That's what I call parties. Mississippi's that was like two different parties. Republicans and Democrats and so independents. Guys, we have the same thing. So that's how things went on, and we're doing fine. That's why I wrote the song. Earlier, I performed it. It's called Red Rocks the Earth. That's dedicated to my family side of the Seminole. Also, I was working with them at the time. I opened my company. I have a company that does marketing and PR, international, global marketing for Native American tourism development. So I took it out as a project and ran with that, and it was good. The place is great, but it inspired me. When they bought the Hard Rock International and went global for the first time, an American Indian tribe in America went global and bought Hard Rock International. It inspired me to write Red Rocks the Earth. And we do now. It's true, literally, by contract,